Hi, I am Blaze from SceneMorph. In this video, I will show you how to make jump automation in Cubase. Probably you have already faced this problem. You would like to make simple jump automation in Cubase to automate volume, setting the level of different syllables of a vocal track, or just any parameter modulations. But it was hard to accomplish because you couldn't draw straight, vertical and horizontal lines to shape the curve precisely. In Steinberg forum, I saw people wanted to achieve this by changing some commands into macros, which can be quite complicated in certain situations. So I will show you a much easier way to make jump automation. As an example, I'm using this vocal recording of the Cubase demo song called 8 Good Reasons. This is just for demonstration, so this vocal is already well balanced, so I am just showing you how to reduce or increase the level of certain words on this vocal track. Okay, let's jump into it. First, select the line tool, the square waveform. To select it, just press and hold the mouse button and select the square. Now choose the audio track and open the volume automation lane. Now, let's locate the part of the audio file where you want to make a volume jump. For instance, I would like to reduce the volume of this part of the audio by -6 dB. Now, press and hold Ctrl+Shift on PC or Command+Shift on Mac while the line tool is being selected and drag the mouse from one side to the other. The direction left to right or right to left doesn't matter. And voila! Now we have a very precise jump automation, which doesn't affect the volume before and after the jumps. Now let's switch back to the selection tool. I'm pressing its shortcut number 1 and select the necessary point at the edge. Now you can move the selection with the left and right arrows between the points. You see? I'm moving it left and right. By pressing Shift plus the arrows, you have to select at least 2 consecutive points. Now, as you see, the automation range is displayed and you have 2 different ways to set the volume level here. The first, just use the scale vertical tool in the bounding box, which is called the automation event editor, and move this line up and down. The other method, you can set the value on the info line here at the top and move it up and down. Or with Shift you can fine tune it, or even double click and enter a precise value like -6 dB. All these changes are immediately reflected on the volume fader if the play bar is set within this automation range. So this is it. Again, some more example, let's see how to make it. So Ctrl+Shift and drag. Release. Ctrl+Shift, drag and release. Hold Ctrl+Shift, drag, release. Hold Ctrl+Shift, drag and release. So it's quite easy. Another thing, sometimes my Cubase student tell me that this is a trim automation. So even if it's being referred as a trim automation, it's not. Trim automation is a different thing that can apply to current automation curves to rescale their effect. So if you select here in the automation panel the trim and you switch it on the right mode as well, then you can move up and down the whole range, or you can rescale it, whatever. So I would rather call it jump automation instead, where the automation points instantly jump straight from the previous curve point to the new one without any transition. So, all in all, even if it's not so obvious, the jump automation becomes quite manageable with this little trick using the line automation tool in Cubase. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Please visit my website at scenemorph.com for more tips. If you have any question or comment, just enter it below. Also, if you find it useful, please subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook. Have a nice day.